Welcome back to my channel. If you're new, I'm Rai, and this is Rai's Reading Corner. And today I am bringing you a birthday book haul. Birthday was April 8th, and I was gifted many amazing books and some gift cards to purchase some books, and I am very thankful for everyone that has gifted me these beautiful, amazing books. So I'm super, super excited to share with all of you some of the books that I received as gifts for my birthday. But quickly, again, if you are new, welcome. Make sure you hit that subscribe button so you do not miss any of my content, and make sure you, all of you, press that notification button, the little bell, so you get alerted whenever I post something new. So for this video, I will be kind of separating these into books that were given to me as gifts, books that I bought as gifts with like gift cards I got for my birthday, and then there are some bookish items that I received that I would love to share with you too, and I will do that at the end. So let's get started. Okay, so the first book I received was from my husband, and that is The Once and Future Witches by Alexis E. Harrow. I love books about witches. I actually am dedicating a whole shelf on my bookshelf just to books that have witches and witchcraft in it. I've actually already read this book, but I loved the color. It has the deckled edges on this book. This is about three sisters who are reunited, and they are come together through this magic, and it is takes place after the Salem witch trials. They live in a place called New Salem, and they are fighting against the men's superiority and women's suffrage through coming together with women through witchcraft and witching. And it is such a good book, but I'm not gonna review it. But yes, definitely super excited that I got this book for my birthday. The next book was a gift from my brother, and this is Every Vow You Break by Peter Swanson. This is the author from 8 Perfect Murders, which I read at the end of last year and really, really liked. I don't know much about this. Any of the thrillers that I really have in this pile, you'll notice that I don't know much about them because I like going into thrillers not knowing much because it makes it that much more exciting. But from what I've read from the synopsis really quickly, it talks about a bride's dream honeymoon becomes a nightmare when a man with whom she has a regrettable one-night stand shows up in the electrifying psychological thriller. So I'm super excited. It's not a really long book. 8 Perfect Murders was not long either. I love a good psychological thriller, so I'm super excited to read another one of Peter Swanson's book. So this next book was gifted to me by Eric. He is awesome. I am going to link his channel down below. He gifted to me this book when he found out I was pregnant, so I would have something to read on my maternity leave. And this is a popular thriller that a lot of people seem to love, and that is When No One Is Watching by Alyssa Cole. So I know, I believe she's dabbled in romance before. I want to say this was her first thriller, but don't quote me on that. I heard this is really kind of creepy. It talks about with paranoia and fear in a neighborhood, and that's as much as I know about it, and that's all I want to know because, like I said before, I want to be surprised when I go into reading a thriller, so I am super excited about this one. The next book was, again, gifted by one of my amazing friends here on BookTube, and that is Chelsea. She is a fellow mom who loves to read like me. Again, I will link her channel down below. And this is a book that has been, I feel like, been taking this book world by storm, and that is Amari and the Night Brothers by B.B. Elston. This is a middle grade book. I don't know too much about it. Just that there is magic, it's fantasy, and people are saying this is absolutely an amazing book, and I'm really excited to dive into it. I think the cover is super pretty. I love the blue, and then this is the hardcover, what it looks like naked, which is even gorgeous as well. It has the title on the side, and then the inside covers are this, or the inside pages are this really pretty pale blue color. Yeah, it's just really, really gorgeous book all around. And I'm super excited. So again, thank you, Chelsea, for gifting this to me for my birthday. All right, the next book was gifted by my parents. And this is a the last book in a series. And this is Girls with Rebel Souls by Suzanne Young. Again, such a pretty cover. This is the Girl with Sharp Sticks series. Also, Girl with Razor Hearts is book number 2. It's about a academy where people would send these girls, very prestigious, to pretty much be taught how to please a man or a man by obeying everything that they say, that you have no say. And but it was really seen as being prestigious to go there, but it's not all what it seems. And this book is about rebellion and fighting for, you know, to be, have your rights and freedoms and being a woman. And it's just really, really good. And it's by Suzanne Young, who I try to talk about a lot on my channel because I really, really like her writing. She wrote The Program series, which is a 6-book series. This is, like I said, the last one in this trilogy, and I'm super, super excited to finish off this series. All right, the next 2 books are books, again, that my brother and his fiance gifted me, and this one is The Hating Game by Sally Thorne. This is a office hate-to-love romance. I feel like everyone just loves this, and I feel like I'm really behind on reading this. I know it's Kirsten from Kirsten's Corner, one of her favorite romances, and I'm super excited. I think it's about, like, they're both going for a promotion, but all I needed to hear was hate to love, and I was sold, and I'm super excited to be diving into this one soon. All right, and the last gift that was gifted to me, and this is Shadow and Bone by Lee Bargudo. I don't know much about this. What has kind of pushed me to want to read this is everyone talks about it is one, and I'm falling into that type of it, but also it is coming to Netflix, and I would like to watch this, and I feel like there's gonna be a lot of spoily stuff coming out, and I want to read the book before anything is spoiled for me. So I just know that this is a YA fantasy, I believe, don't quote me on it, I think it's YA, and that's literally all I know about it. But I do love the color, except the obnoxious Netflix thing on there. It's not a sticker, it does not come off, but it also has this really pretty, like, inside cover as well. So for a paperback, super, super gorgeous, and I'm excited to kind of dabble in the Grishaverse and see how I feel about it. All right, so the next books are books that I was given as gift cards, and I have purchased these books. A lot of people that I usually see for gifts, we're not seeing, obviously, at Nine now because of COVID, and they just sent me a gift card. So I have purchased several books from them, and I also have more money to spend on books with gift cards. So if there's any books you think I need to have in my collection, please drop them down in the comments below. So the first book I purchased, I'm super, super excited, it's a new release, and that is Lost in the Neverwoods by Aidan Thomas. This is the author of Cemetery Boys, which I did read this year. I received it for Christmas. This is a Peter Pan retelling, and you know that I most of the time say I don't care about retellings in general, but I am super intrigued by this book. We have Wendy. She, it's been 5 years since Wendy and her brothers have vanished, and she, I believe, comes back, and she doesn't have any memory of what has happened to her. And then more children start disappearing, and then she meets a boy named Peter, and they help to try and find the kids. Sounds really interesting. It kind of gives me a little bit of Once Upon a Time vibes, and that is one of my favorite shows of all times, so I'm really excited to dive into this one. And I, like I said, I really liked Cemetery Boys and Aidan Thomas's writing. The cover is so nice and gorgeous as well. The inside, again, is this blue with this really, really pretty pink on the side for the title, and then the end pages are, again, this really pretty pastel pink. Totally vibing and feeling it. So super excited that I was able to pick this up. The next book I purchased is one that a series that I just recently read for Becca's Bookopolathon. I had started it then, and that is the Nevermore series. So I got the second book, and this is Wondersmith, The Calling of Morrigan Crow by Jessica Townsend. This is another middle grade book fantasy. If you're not familiar with this storyline, we have our main character, Morrigan Crow, and she, when she was born, was destined to die at a very young age. And she is whisked away and she is brought to this new alternate place where she has to compete in this competition. And if she gets a spot in this like academy or this like I would say academy almost, she is able to live, and there's different trials and competitions, and yeah, it's just really, really good, and I'm explaining it really bad, but I feel like a lot of people know what Nevermore is about, and so this is the sequel. It is a chunkier book, but since it is middle grade, it reads really fast, and the pages are smaller, so it reads pretty good. All right, and the last book that I purchased for myself, and I loved the book by this author that I read recently, and so this is Kristen Hannah, and this is The Nightingale, and this is historical fiction. I'm so excited to read this, and this one takes place with World War II, which is some of my favorite historical fiction to read about. I honestly don't know anything more about that. I just know that people absolutely love this book. I read The Great Alone last month, and it's probably going to be one of my top books of the year. I absolutely just adored it, and this book I heard is just so good as well. So yeah, I'm really excited to dive into another one of Kristen Hannah's books, and hopefully I continue to love her as an author. All right, so the last two books were book of the month books, but I decided to include them in here because when you become a BFF member, they call it, of their of them, you get a book for free on your birthday. So I was able to get two books because I had a credit as well as my free birthday one. And so the first book I got was People We Met on Vacation, or We Meet on Vacation, by Emily Henry. She's the one that wrote Beach Read, which I absolutely loved. I don't know too much about this, just that it is a romance that occurs in the summer, and it's like a one last chance like fall in love book. The cover gives me such fun summer vibes, and yeah, I'm super excited. Like I said, Beach Read was a really successful read for me, and I have high hopes for Emily Henry's new book. And the last book that I got from Book of the Month, it was The Arsenic and Adobo, or Adobo, I think, by Mia P. Mansala. I probably butchered that and I really apologize. This isn't really released. It does not come out till May, but this is a thriller and I don't know too much about it. It seems to more be like a cozy mystery thriller. The cover, I love the cover because it's not what you would typically expect from a thriller book, but I know someone about an ex-boyfriend or a boyfriend gets killed, and she, I believe, is a suspect. I could totally be wrong, but I've heard a lot of people talking about that they're really super excited for this book, and I am excited as well. So those were the books that I received from my amazing friends and family. So like I said, I also did get some fun bookish items that I would like to share with all of you. Okay, so the first one is from Kirsten. Me and Kirsten have become like really, really good friends. We talk all the time from Kirsten's Corner. Again, I'll link her channel down below. And she sent me a birthday gift, and this is a book stamp to go inside my books, and it says "from the property of," and it has my first and last name on it. So I am not going to show you this part because I don't want to put my full name out there, but it's really cute. So you just open up your book and you stamp it and it comes out, and it's really cool. It has like my name and like fancy script and stuff, so really, really cute. And again, "from the property of," and again, there is my first and last name. So super, super cute, really creative, and I love it, and I love Kirsten. So again, thank you, Kirsten, for that. Last thing that I would like to share with you again that I got for my birthday, and this is a really cool sign that my husband got me for my bookcases, and because it reminded him of my intro with the green sign where it says "Rise Reading Corner," and so he got me this cool street sign made with "Rise Reading Corner" on it as a decoration for my bookshelves. Super sweet and creative, and I love it, and it will be displayed in where all my bookcases are in my bedroom. I pretty much have taken over the bedroom. I have tons of bookcases in here and books, and my poor husband has like nothing in here. But so I'm super excited to display this, and it was a super sweet gift. So yeah, I had a great birthday and I got so many amazing gifts. And again, like I said, I have more gift cards left. So if there's anything I need to add, you think, to my book collection, please leave it down in the comments below. So again, make sure you subscribe and press that notification button. If you want to be my friend on any of my other social media platforms, I have all that linked down in the bio below. So everyone stay kind, and I'll see you next time. Bye. So pretty up front.